fight together. Nothing can free opponents now. Ah, 2 for 1. 3 minutes left. 3 opponents down. Double down. 3 opponents down. I know a comeback when I see one. Fight on!
Ladies and gents, my name is Xander, aka Diaside, and in this video, we're going to discuss the absolute must-have god roll guide to every single Sundial weapon that you can possibly imagine. Now, some of you might be asking yourself the question, Xander, why the heck are you going over all these weapons right now? And the answer to this is that we are currently donating a tremendous amount of polarized fractiline to this obelisk in the tower, so then that way we can possibly get a new event. Trials, maybe? I think so, but that's all speculation, so we're going to find out for sure once this event's actually done. And so in the meantime, what I want you to do is simply go to the Tower Obelisk, pick up some bounties of the weapon of your choosing, and then donate 400 polarized fractiline. Bada bing, bada boom, just like that, we're going to get some crazy rolls, and we can do this over and over again, and thus this means to us, God Roll Farm, baby. In understanding that, I want you to know that the only weapons that we're not going to cover is this season's Sniper and Rocket Launcher, followed by the Black Scorpion, the Bygones, and the Last Perdition. But as far as everything else goes, every single God Roll guy that you're about to see is going to have 2 perks in every single column. The reason for this is because I want you to have the most optimal ideal role for what we're going to talk about, and that is of course PvP. So understanding this, the only thing left to do is just to simply sit back, relax, grab some Twizzlers, and eviscerate the notification button, and let's jump right into the video. As you all currently view the weapons that I'm going to review right there on screen, by all means feel free and be my guest to skip around to the video that you want to see, but also realize that what I'm doing first is I'm going to cover every single weapon's base stats. I do this because it's a very good indicator to understand as to how these things are then structured in terms of their strengths and weaknesses via those base stats, so then we can really get a better comprehension as to what we should look for, not just in terms of damage buffing perks and things like that, but more importantly, something like say reload perks, or range perks, or handling perks, or whatever it might be, to complement and compensate for those weapons base stats. First up is Saint 14's beautiful shotgun, and it's called the Perfect Paradox. Understand that with shotguns, what we're trying to look for is we're trying to increase the weapon's overall base range factors, while also trying to increase the aim assistance to make it once again more consistent. When it comes to using the Perfect Paradox, I want to show you guys all its base stats right there on screen. And as you can tell, its base range stat isn't that great and it's only at 39, but its overall aim assistance is pretty darn freaking good at 70, and its recoil direction is decent as well at 61, but as far as the handling speed goes, we definitely want to increase that even more so to get a faster ADS speed. The reason why these things are so important to know is because for a shotgun, we of course want to increase its range so then it can be more effective at longer distances, but simultaneously, we also want to increase the handling speed so then we can ADS faster and compress the pellet spread, thus making the weapon more consistent. If at all possible, we definitely want to increase the weapon's aim assistance just the same, and also remember that this is a full auto shotgun, so if we want to double tap somebody just like in Zombieland, then we also want to try and make sure that their recoil direction is vertical along with the balance intensity and make it much smaller. And having said that, you guys can see all the perks that I recommend for this beauty right there on screen. And it's got a rifle barrel along with full choke in the first column, followed by either light mag or accurized rounds in the second column, ensued by demolitionist and slide shot in the third column, and finally either rampage or opening shot in the fourth column. If it was me, I'm 110% looking for opening shot, slide shot, accurized rounds, and full choke or rifle barrel. The reason why I'm trying to do this is because all those perks that I just mentioned is then going to increase the weapon's overall effective range, and that's exactly what we want these shotguns to be doing. But as far as rampage and demolitionist goes, well, you simply can't go wrong with those either because those are definitely going to come in play, especially when it comes to PvP. However, what I will say is that with rifle barrel, you're probably going to get more guardians at longer distances, yet it probably won't be as consistent as what you would have if you happen to have full choke in those closer range engagements. It's kind of a toss-up as to which one that you really want, but regardless of that, you always know that this thing is going to make enemy guardians a little bit salty. Next up is the Steel Feather Repeater, and might I add that this thing is a beastly godly auto rifle, especially if you happen to have one roll, and we'll talk about that in a second. But to understand why you need that roll, what I want to cover first is the weapon's perks, and we can see all those right there on screen. In terms of these stats, I ain't gonna lie, they're not doing too good, because the weapon's range isn't that great at 32, its stability is despicable and certainly needs to be increased, and it's only at 38, but as far as the weapon's aim assistance goes, That's pretty darn freaking high at 72. Anti-recoil direction isn't that bad, but once again, could definitely be improved, and the reason why we want this to be done is to have it be more consistent. From personal experience, I can definitely say that this auto rifle is going up, down, left, right, and its rate of fire is crazy fast, which then means that it's going to become that much more unpredictable. And so to make it more predictable, what we want to look for on this is some perks that I recommend, and we can see all those right there on screen. In the first column, you really want to have either arrowhead break or chamber compensator, followed by the second column to be either high caliber rounds or ricochet rounds, and so by that third column to be either feeding frenzy or slideways, and last but not least, the fourth column to be either swashbuckler or multi-kill clip. Every single one of those perks that I just mentioned is designed to give the weapon a high lethality factor along with a high consistency factor. And so the one that I was referring to from earlier is to have multi-kill clip, feeding frenzy, arrowhead break, and high caliber rounds. That roll right there is going to be astronomically important and powerful in so many ways that I can't even begin to describe to you as to how amazing that's really going to be. And the reason why it's so is because not only is it going to increase the weapon's TTK with multi-kill clip, but you're going to be able to proc that perk faster with feeding frenzy, and simultaneously you're then going to get tons of flinch with high caliber rounds, all while having to be consistent via arrowhead break or chamber compensator. Now if you really want to have a consistency based roll, then maybe something like say chamber compensator is going to be great, along with ricochet rounds and slideways, as all those perks are not only going to increase the weapon's recoil direction, but they're also then going to increase the weapon's stability, and this thing certainly needs that as a royal flush in order to clean house. Now I'm not trying to brag, but I happen to grind for this thing a ton and got the roll that I just described to you, which I think is truly the ultimate god roll. So if you want to see that video down in the comment section below, then by all means let me know. But for now, the next thing that we've got to cover is this amazing sidearm, and it's called the Breachlight. As the game currently stands, sidearms are in an amazing spot, and this Breachlight actually made my top 5 sidearms list, and so if you want to see that, then I'll link it in the top right hand corner of your screen this very second. But as far as the Breachlight itself goes in its base stats, well, it's definitely got some things that are awesome, and quite a few things that are lacking, and to see what I mean by this, we're going to see all the weapon's base stats right there on screen. Its range stat is superb at 53 out of 100, but its stability stat is definitely lacking only at 43, yet its aim assistance is exceptional at 82, and its recoil direction is just the same at 82. With all those things that I've just mentioned, the weapon's shot rhythm is going to be fantastic, and we can actually increase how this thing's then going to feel via that shot rhythm with a couple of perks. What perks, you ask? Well, Diaslayers, that is a glorious question, and to see all the ones that I recommend, we're going to see those right there on screen. In the first column, we happen to have either arrowhead break or chamber compensator, followed by the second column to be drop mag or flare magwell, ensued by the third column to be either demolitionist or outlaw, and finally our fourth column to be either multi-kill clip or rampage. Now one can make the argument that in that fourth column, quick draw is still a very, very good perk, and don't get me wrong, it is. So if you happen to get that, then certainly also consider that weapon as well in the role that you happen to have. But the reason why I mention these perks is because what I want you to have is a high lethality based roll in conjunction with getting your grenade very, very quickly. If you happen to get a roll with something like, say, multi-kill clip, demolitionist, drop mag, and arrowhead break, oh my gosh, that's the roll that I happen to have, and it's an absolute monster. It annihilates, eradicates, and decimates every gun in its path, making them think, what the heck did I just get wrecked by? Simultaneously, that roll is also then going to give you back your grenade energy very, very quickly. But if that's not your cup of tea, then maybe you want something more consistent, and if that's the case, then you might want to go with something like, say, chamber compensator and flare magwell, because those two perks are not only going to increase the recoil direction, but it's also then going to increase the reload speed, and more importantly, the weapon stability, making it that much more consistent. Given some of those perks that I just mentioned, this thing can definitely have a 100 out of 100 recoil direction, and when that's the case, this vertical recoil is just going to be that, vertical and vertical alone, yet again making it more consistent. But something that is completely different from this entire weapon is the Martyr's Retribution. What makes the Martyr's Retribution such a very unique grenade launcher is that when you shoot it onto the ground, it's going to have this wave like that of a thermite grenade, and so it increases the usability of this thing tenfold. But if you want it to be able to be more effective, you might want to use it as a direct hit, and if that's the case, then what you're looking for is some perks to increase the weapon's overall velocity and or blast radius, or the two things combined. To kind of see where the weapon stands as is, I want to show you guys all the weapon's base stats right there on screen. And you can already tell that the velocity is quite high at 76, but the blast radius definitely could be increased a little bit more so, and it's only at 55. Depending on how you want to use this thing, you might want to use it as a direct impact, and so in that sense, the weapon's aim assistance is quite high at 72, and if you want an ADS, then that's also very, very high with a handling speed at 69. For those of you that don't quite have the mountaintop yet, I can definitely say that this thing might just make your journey a little bit easier to get it. And so the perk combination that you're looking for is something that we can see right there on screen. In the first column, we happen to have either Quick Launch or Linear Compensator, followed by the second column to be either High Velocity Rounds or Implosion Rounds. Ensuing this is the third and fourth columns to be either Auto Lane Holster or Underdog, followed by that of Demolitionist and Rangefinder. Pretty much all the perks that I just mentioned for this weapon's second and first column, those are going to either increase the weapon's blast radius or velocity, and so it really just depends upon your playstyle and which one that you want to use or rather increase the most. If you like to damage guardians off with the weapon itself first, and then swap to a secondary weapon, maybe say a duke or something else along those lines, then auto-loading holster is 110% the way to go. But what I also say is that if you want to ADS with this thing, then remember that rangefinder is always going to increase the weapon's velocity as you happen to ADS. Moving on, we had the line in the sand. And although the line in the sand is a very powerful weapon, it's just that, a powerful weapon in the power slot. And so for PvP, I really don't use it for this, but if you really want to use this thing in PvP, then what we have to look at first is the weapon's base stats, so then we can kind of get a better sense as to what strengths and weaknesses really are. As you can see from right there, its range stat is at 36, which really isn't that great. And the reason why I want it to be higher, well, we'll get into that in a little bit. But as far as the aim assistance goes, that's excellent at 60, and for PvP, that's really all that matters. When picking up power ammo, you're really not going to get that many bullets, but when you do happen to do so, you want this thing to have as much bullet magnetism as it possibly can, and the way in which you do that is by increasing its base range stat. Some of the perks that might be able to do that for you is something like what you guys see right there on screen. In that first column, we happen to have two range perks, either Hammer Horse Rifling or Full Bore. After this is the second column, and here I want you to have either Liquid Coils or Projection Fuse, followed by the third column to be Rapid Hit or Rangefinder, and last but not least our fourth column to be either Backup Plan or Firing Line. From a PvP standpoint, I think that your best bet here is to have something like, say, Backup Plan, Rangefinder, Projection Fuse, and Full Bore. And the reason why this is so is because those three perks that I just mentioned are all going to increase the weapon's base range stat, thus increasing its overall ball of magnetism. Is that going to be enough to finish off a guardian who might have a teeny tiny bit of health already gone? Maybe, it just might be able to do so. But once again, you guys already know what's going to work for you to make sure that you get those headshots, and if that's the case, it's going to be like tasting an oh-so-delicious bite of calamari, and that, as always, crispy. Now guys, I'll be frank, the next weapon that we're going to talk about is the Infinite Paths 8, and this thing's sight, oh my gosh, it's the definition of fluff cabbage trash shenanigans. I mean, it's that freaking despicable and terrible on so many levels, because this thing's sight actually blocks so much of your peripheral vision that I can't tell you as to how often I've missed a guardian even when I'm aiming down sights. That to me is mind-boggling, but be forewarned, you've been just that, warned. And so the next thing that we gotta talk about if you wanna use this thing is its weapon's base stats. And so you guys can see all those right there on screen. Its base range stat could definitely use some work, and it's only at 37, but its stability stat isn't that shabby at 55, whereas its aim assistance is pretty darn freaking good at 76, and its recoil direction could use a little bit more work and be better in my opinion to make it that much more consistent, and that's only at 59. I've said it before and I'll say it again, I am a big proponent of shot rhythm. In order for this thing to have that much better of a shot rhythm, then you need to increase this weapon's stability stat, aim assistance, and recoil direction as much as you possibly can. And the reason why this is so is because you want to make that recoil just vertical and vertical alone, landing more shots, also trying to condense the bullets in between bullets themselves and also the bullets in between bursts, so then you get that much more of a consistent factor going. When coupled together with a couple of perks, what I just described to you is certainly possible. And so what I want to show you next is the perks that I recommend, and we can see all those right there on screen. In the first and second columns, we got Arrowhead Break, Chamber Compensator, Steady Rounds, and Flared Magwell. Following that is the third and fourth columns, and here we happen to see Demolitionist, Moving Target, Swashbuckler, and Zen Moment. To get the most consistent roll and have this thing be an absolute laser beam that simply just doesn't miss shots, what you're looking for is Zen Moment, Moving Target, Steady Rounds, and Arrowhead Break. That right there could be an excellent perk combination, and it could do very, very good for, once again, consistency. But if you're looking for something that might have a little bit of a difference in something like, say, damage buff, or something like, say, grenade recharge, then what you're looking for here is Swashbuckler and Demolitionist. If I'm being crystal clear, I would say that this thing is really not in the best places, at least when it comes to PvP. Maybe in PvE, it's amazing, but as far as PvP goes, there's definitely some better options. But another weapon that just might pique your interest even more so than this thing is a fusion rifle, and it's called the Gallant Charge. I know, the Aaron Tail is an absolute monster in PvP right now, but if you want to, I strongly encourage you to try and change things up, as you might just happen to like this gallant charge even more so. And so to really get a better understanding of what this thing is actually doing, we gotta look at the weapon's base stats, and we can see all those right there on screen. Its range stat is oh so wondrous at 53, but its stability stat is terrible at 31, and its aim assistance is just mediocre at 61, whereas its recoil direction is looking quite promising at 76. The reason why I mentioned those four stats is because with fusion rifles, what you're always trying to do is you're trying to compress the bolt spread as much as you possibly can. The more that you can compress the spread via increasing the weapon's stability stat and its recoil direction stat, that's then going to mean that you're going to have a lot more chances to actually hit a lot more bullets, even at cross-map distances. And if you want to increase the odds of landing more of those cross-map shots even more so, then having a high range stat is yet again vital. To see some of the perks that might just give the Aaron Tail a run for its money, I want to show you all the ones that I recommend right there on screen. And in the first column, we happen to have Arrowhead Break along with Chamber Compensator, instead by the second column to be that of Particle Repeater and Projection Fuse. Now we can't forget that third and fourth column, and so here we happen to have Demolitionist with Auto-Loading Holster, followed by that of Rangefinder and Tap the Trigger. If you're looking to get the most consistent roll that you possibly can, and maybe just give the Aaron Tail a backslap, oh that's gonna be so gratifying, then what you're looking for is Tap the Trigger, Particle Repeater, and Arrowhead Break without a question in my mind. You can obviously tell that that just might be a fantastic combination of perks. But if that's not your cup of tea, then don't worry, because what you can also do is use something like, say, Rangefinder and Demolitionist. That combination of perks just might be able to cross map guardians at distances that's not gonna just surprise you, but also surprise them, saying Chucky gotcha. The next weapon that I want to talk about is the Jack Queen King, and this bad boy is back and better than ever. And might I add, that it can be extremely consistent, especially in those close to mid-range distances, and the fact that it's a 150 means that it's got the exact same optimal time to kill as a spare rations at 0.8 seconds. Some might even argue that this thing right here is actually more consistent than that of the spare rations. And the reason why this is so, well, you're gonna find out right now by looking at the weapon's base stats. It's got a base range, which is just mediocre at 45, but it's got an okay stability stat at 41, but where this thing really shines is its aim assistance at 91 and a recoil direction at 100, followed by a bounce intensity that is not only vertical, but at zero. This then means to us that this weapon's shot rhythm is going to be outstanding and probably one of the best shot rhythms out of any other hand cannon in the entire game. If you're looking for that consistent 3-tap, then this Jack Queen King can easily do that on a very regular basis, and a roll that just might happen to do so is something like what you guys see right there on screen. And going from left to right, the first column happens to have True Sight HCS, followed by Hitmark HCS, and then we happen to have High Caliber Rounds or Ricochet Rounds, followed by Demolitionist and Subsistence, and of course, Rampage and Snapshot in that fourth column. Roll that I'm looking for here to trump all other aces is Rampage, Subsistence, High Caliber Rounds, and True Sight HCS. I want this roll because number one, it's going to give me a damage buff as I'm stacking more stacks of Rampage, but at the same time, Subsistence is then going to give me more bullets as soon as I happen to get more kills, and you can see the beautiful symbiotic relationship between that of Rampage and Subsistence. However, you might want to pair this thing with a sniper rifle, and if that's the case, what you're looking for is Snapshot, Demolitionist, and Ricochet Rounds. If you happen to get a body shot with your sniper, then easy peasy lemon squeezy. You whip out this bad boy, as it's then going to have Snapshot to get that very nice cleanup, you're then going to get your grenade energy back via Demolitionist. Is this Jack King Queen going to be my go-to hand cannon? No, it's definitely not, as I love my Kindle of the Orchid, since that thing can 2-tap on so many occasions. But having said that, you guys know your playstyle better than anybody else. And something that actually might pique your interest instead of this beauty is something like, say, the Patron of Lost Causes. I know there's a ton of Guardians out there who love Scout Rifles, and this Patron of Lost Causes can do exceptionally well and can be very, very consistent simultaneously. And so to really see how this can be even more consistent than what you might think, what we gotta look at first is the weapon's base stats. Of all the stats that you see right there, its two weakest factors is its range at 40 and its stability at 39, and those are really just terrible. But as far as the weapon's aim assistance and recoil directions go, those are looking pretty darn sweet, especially when they're quite similar at 67 and 59 respectively. Unfortunately, that stability stat and range stat is just hideous, but the bright side here is that we can actually make this thing much more consistent in multiple of those factors if we happen to look at the weapon's perks. And those perks that I recommend are right there on screen. In the first column, we got either Arrowhead Break or Chamber Compensator, followed by the second column to be Steady Rounds and Flare Magwell, allowing this to be followed by either rapid hit and full auto, and last but not least, explosive payload or opening shots. And using this thing for a decent amount of time, what I will say is that what this thing definitely needs is a very fast reload speed, as you're going to burn through bullets extremely fast. And simultaneously, you want to have a high stability stat, as that's then going to increase the weapon's overall consistency. And when you couple it with some perks that might increase the weapon's recoil direction, then that's when we get a very, very consistent weapon. And with a cherry on top turning this thing into an ice cream sundae delight, explosive payload is going to make this thing flinch enemy guardians so much that they're going to be shredded just like the Shredder from Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. At the end of the day, let me assure you that this thing is definitely going to get guardians at cross-map distances as if taking candy from a baby. But something that's going to do the exact opposite of this is something that's going to be used in close-quarters combat, and that thing is called a Traveler's Judgment. The Traveler's Judgment is arguably one of the best sidearms in the entire game, and many of you think that truly is the best sidearm in the entire game. And once again, I remind you that if you want to see my top 5 sidearms list, then by all means, that's still up on the top right-hand corner of your screen this very second. But as to why this might be true for some of you, this Traveler's Judgment's base stats might indicate that, and we can see all those right there on screen. Its base range stat really is just mediocre, only at 45, but its stability stat is just out of this world crazy and mind-boggling at 84, followed by the weapon's aim assistance at 70, its outstanding recoil direction at 89, and its very minuscule bounce intensity going to the left only at 11. What these base stats should indicate to you is that this thing's shot rhythm is just outrageous, and it can get even better if we happen to increase the weapon's stability stat, possibly making it 100 out of 100. Likewise, we can also do the same thing with the weapon's recoil direction, making it just that, 100 out of 100. And when this is the case, I can definitely say that this thing right here just might be the most consistent weapon, or rather the most consistent sidearm in the entire game, and some of the perks that just might do that is the ones that we see right there on screen. And going from left to right, the perks are in the following order. Quick dot SAS, control SAS, high caliber rounds or ricochet rounds, rapid hit or feeding frenzy, and tap the trigger or headseeker. All those perks that I just mentioned are amazing, but if you really want to land crits for decades, then what you're looking for is either to have tap the trigger and rapid hit, along with that of ricochet rounds or high caliber rounds. Depending on your playstyle, you might want to cause a ton of flinch to enemy guardians, and if that's the scenario, then high caliber rounds is easily the way to go. But if you want to increase the weapon's stability stat to potentially 100 out of 100, then ricochet rounds is a clear-cut choice. Following this exact same thought process, you can actually increase the weapon's stability stat even more so, and its reload speed simultaneously via rapid hit, which is why I want those two combinations of perks to be together. But then also when you happen to include tap the trigger, oh my gosh, that thing's accuracy is going to go skyrocketing through the roof every single trigger pull, and once again, this is why this thing could potentially be the most consistent sidearm. Now some of you might be thinking, Xander, if I happen to get that roll on this sidearm, is it going to become the best sidearm in the entire game? For some of you it might, and for others it definitely is not, and for me personally, I'll say that it's not and last hope holds that spot, but by all means, let me know what you guys think about everything that I've just said, not just for the sidearm, but for all the roles that I mentioned in the entire video. I think that this is a very, very good starting point for all you guys who want to grind as many god rolls as you possibly can, and right now, that's 110% the time to do so. I mean, come on, it's a no-brainer to do so, as all you need is 400 fractiline, and then bada bing bada boom, you got so many god rolls, and it's probably even easier than what Yugi had in summoning all 3 Egyptian god cards, but hey, no matter what the outcome is, you guys always know that I'm going to respect your opinions, and that's something that I can guarantee. Lastly, be sure to watch the newest, check the latest, and share a comment like on social media, because you are the greatest. That's much all I've got for you as of right now, Diaslayers, and as always, GG TNT.